Welcome to Tales from SYL Ranch, where everyone is entitled to my opinion, and I'm Bill Stone. A lot's been made recently of President Trump not turning over his tax returns to Congress. Well, I don't think he should turn over his tax returns. Understand that I am not a Trump supporter. I am a libertarian, and I would not vote for neither a Republican nor a Democrat if you put a gun to my head. But the fact is, a billionaire's tax returns will be long and complex. If you think you have it bad trying to fill out a tax form, billionaires don't just hire a single accountant to work for them. They have entire teams on their payroll. Not only that, but they have to file quarterly rather than just annually. And I am rather familiar with this because my father was a psychologist who had his own practice for 50 years, and he routinely got into it with the IRS. And he passed away just a few years ago. But despite the fact that he passed away years ago, his taxes on that business are just now winding down. Last year, for example, the IRS lost over $8,000 in one quarter, and my mom spent a year arguing with them about it, and I ultimately became involved, and I found that they had it, but it took 8 months worth of paperwork to do it. And additionally, my mother spent more in taxes last year than she earned, and that was on a business that has been defunct for years. Various laws, you see, would not allow for its complete dissolution for that length of time. And since my mom inherited the corporation and was then its president and CEO, my mom had to keep paying taxes on it until the law allowed for its dissolution last year. Now, by the way, the IRS finds that she overpaid last year and they're giving her refund checks. And that's how bad it is for a one-man corporation and a single private accountant on a business whose offices have been shuttered for years. Now multiply that by a billion, and you have Trump's tax returns. They got to be filled with junk that ultimately devolves to tax law is fracked up beyond repair, the IRS is fracking incompetent from top to bottom, and just fights over what tax law means what applied to what business. Trump's tax returns would just be a propagandist's field today that really amounted to normal operations with tax law and the IRS. I would not give him up my tax returns in his shoes either. Now, associated with this are 17 states right now that are working to keep Trump off their ballots by passing laws requiring candidates to release their tax returns. Those of you in those states need to understand that this is obviously unconstitutional. The Constitution defines the requirements to hold the office of president. Article 2, Section 1 of the U.S. Constitution states, "No person except a natural-born citizen or a citizen of the United States at the time of the adoption of this Constitution shall be eligible for the office of president. Neither shall any person be eligible to that office who shall not have attained the age of 35 years and been 14 years a resident within the United States." So the Constitution says absolutely nothing about releasing taxes. The 17 states considering this move, if they succeed, then after the election, the constitutionality of those laws will be taken to the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court will have no choice but to declare them obviously unconstitutional. And this will result in the invalidation of those states' elections and the invalidation of any electors sent to the Electoral College by those states, which will then mean ignoring that state's electors. So if, for example, California passes a law requiring the presidential candidates to release their tax returns, then all 55 of California's electors will be ignored in the general election. This would almost certainly result in an instant landslide win for Trump. And it would probably also result in riots and chaos, both in California and in any other state that unconstitutionally passed this law. And given the political climate, probably violence more generally throughout the United States. So those of you in states attempting to pass this kind of law need to tread very, very carefully, because you are first slitting your own throats, and secondly, you are driving this country ever closer to civil war. And that is all that I have to say about that subject for today. So thank you very much for watching. If you like what I'm doing, please do like the video, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, share me on social media, and tell all of your friends, family, neighbors, pets, and livestock to do the same. I would certainly appreciate your support, either via Subscribestar, my PayPal tip jar, or a place on my website where you can support me further. And there are links to all of those in my description box below. So thanks for watching Tales from SYL Ranch. And remember, for a breath of fresh air, watch Tales from SYL Ranch, where everyone is entitled to my opinion. And I'm Bill Stone.
Ultimate power in this world has always been one simple thing: the control and manipulation of minds.